Mr. Chairman, sir, I rise to support the demands for grants for the Ministry of Agriculture. I compliment our Honorable Minister, who is keeping in view the dreams of our father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, who always felt and said that the progress of India lies in the progress of rural India. Sir, we have to fulfill the aspirations of the people of rural India. We have to make their dream come true. More than 70% of the people dwell in rural India. Therefore, a new democracy was introduced after the independence of India, and all our stalwarts who came and who adorned this august house, whether they were in opposition or in position, they also felt that agriculture is one of the most important aspects of livelihood of the Indian people. Sir, I do not deny the contribution of the opposition leaders and the opposition stalwarts who adorned this house and contributed to the welfare of India, but I will be failing in my duty if I do not pay my compliments to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. If Mahatma Gandhi is the father of the nation, I will call Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru as the father of India's democracy. He had capable colleague with him, and with the capable colleagues and stalwarts in the opposition, he built a modern, self-reliant India, and he dreamed to make India beautiful and self-respecting. Like a true Gandhian, he started his movement and he thought of rural India. He knew what the land of India needs. There used to be famine earlier, but he said that India needs it water. So he started programs to harness the rivers. He knew that we need power, and so he started power stations. That is how we started building up our India with the help of our great leaders like Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. We started building up a self-reliant India, the fruits of which we are now reaping in this august house. We are discussing the progress of rural India. After Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Shri Lal Bahadur Shastri started a movement called Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. This movement also picked up. We started growing more food for the people of our country. Srimati Indira Gandhi completed the task of Green Revolution. Sir, about agriculture, I would like to say that the farmers of India always stood by the needs of the country. If the Green Revolution is successful, it is because of the sweat and blood of the farmers of our country. In the same way, I would like to say that so far as our fishermen are concerned, if the farmers grow food for us from the soil, the fishermen go deep into the sea and fight with the waves and strong currents of the sea and bring food for us from the sea. But unfortunately, we give incentives to them to produce more, and we do not give many incentives to them for earning more. A farmer needs good seeds, favorable weather, fertilizers, pesticides, water, electricity, and his own hard labor, etc. In the same way, a fisherman needs good boat, good nets, good weather, favorable sea, suitable places to anchor his boat. All these things cost money, labor, and a lot of risk to life. But the price fixed for their labor and yield is much less than the labor and money involved. We should not forget that a farmer or a fisherman has to raise his family, educate his children, take care of their health, and he has to see to it that he gets his children married with respect and dignity. He can manage all these things from the yield of his fields, of the catch of fish from the sea. Today, with the essential commodities of life becoming very expensive, it will be fair on the part of the government to give responsible and fair price to the yields of the farmers and the fishermen. Our farmers toil in the villages. They cannot provide full, proper, nutritious diet to their children. I'm sure our Honorable Minister, being a farmer himself, will do the needful. I know that he has many programs and he will definitely take care of the smallest of the farmers. Further, about civil supplies and public distribution system, I feel that everything looks very rosy on paper, but at the grassroots level, the enthusiasm fades away. What we need is a social and moral commitment from the members of the government, politicians or bureaucrats, and the shopkeepers who have got license to distribute the various essential commodities of life. They all must have a commitment that any foodstuff that reaches the poorest of the poor and foodstuff that reaches the villages will be pure of good quality and wholesome. Sir, I thank you at last. Mr. Chairman, sir, I am thankful to the honorable members for offering their views. Everybody expressed his sympathy for the farmers. There can be nothing more important than this for us. Some of our friends say that 70% people depend on agriculture. I believe that 100% people depend on it. If the stomach is empty, nothing runs smooth. Some of our honorable friends are saying that production has declined and food grains are not available. It is not that there was no agriculture policy earlier and there is none now. It is also not that we are running the government without any policy. Had it been so, we would not have commended the farmers. We would not have praised them that they have shouldered the responsibility of the whole country. Earlier, the population of the country was 34 crores, whereas it has exceeded 125 crores now. Earlier, we required 50 million tons and now our requirement is 300 million tons. It is needless to say that still we require more food grains. We are moving ahead and expecting increase in agriculture production. On the other hand, nobody sees that production has increased. People will complain that they are not getting sufficient food. It is because every year there is an increase of 2 crores people in the country. How can it be checked? We shall have to think over it. There is no expansion in the land area. It remains static. We shall have no consider all these points. Everybody asks me about the agriculture policy and what I was going to do. A system is being followed right from the beginning that production increases in the same ratio. There should be cooperation from both sides. Nothing can be done single-handedly. Our scientists are busy in research. Had there been no coordination and encouragement from the government, perhaps we would not have achieved that much progress. My efforts are also aimed at it. During the course of the debate, there was a reference to Bhanu Pratap Committee. It was alleged that the recommendations of the committee were not implemented properly. They were discussed in the cabinet but were not implemented because of certain considerations. It is the demand of everyone, including the honorable member, that the farmers should be paid remunerative prices for their produce. At the same time, inability to pay remunerative prices is also expressed. I feel sorry at the beginning of wheat during the protest staged on 6th. This pained me much because we are equally concerned about the welfare of the farmers. You people persistently raise the demand for payment of higher prices to farmers for their produce. Agriculture is my only vocation, which I did myself and did not pursue another profession. One honorable member inquired from me about the total land in my possession and whether I have distributed it or not. I would like to submit that I was the first person to have invited people for distributing land with ownership rights. You people can yourself witness how I have converted the barren land into the fertile land. The area which was once a desert now abounds in greenery and stands as a beautiful oasis. I love both nature and farmers. I love plants like my own offsprings. That is why I do not want to hurt the farmers' sentiments, nor am I against payment of remunerative prices to farmers for their produce. However, besides this, we also have to think of the interests of the nation while taking care of our farmers. Farmers have voluntarily done a lot for the country. Farmers have not got involved in any sort of corrupt practice, that is black marketing, hoarding and profiteering. But if the demand is made for excessive increase in prices of agricultural products, it is not correct. Decision to import wheat is also opposed. It is another matter whether the imported wheat has arrived or not. The ministry has stated that the wheat has not yet been arrived. Can the purchasing of a medicine for a patient suddenly fallen ill be postponed for the next day if the medicine is available at higher price in the night? You have alleged that as per our promise, we could not roll back prices within 100 days. How can it be achieved that day? We will have to see things in the right perspective and also to keep a proper check and balance between various things. If the farmers' interests are to be watched, then we will have to watch the interests of the common man too. We will have to consider the condition of the farmers and the poor both. Therefore, I announce the payment of bonus of rupees 50 per quintal on wheat over and above the procurement price.